This adventure began in Madrid, as I drove once again to the historic Cuatro Vientos Airport. Here, I was met by Michel Gordillo, a record-breaking aviator who has been a good friend over the years. We looked around the new displays commemorating the 1936 flight of the Commonwealth, where Filipino aviators Juan Calvo and Antonio Arnaiz flew from Manila to Madrid on a Fairchild Model 24.
It was an epic flight that I think is very important for Spain.
And I'm also very proud of them. I'm still hoping, Michel, that I can do the same trip, but no, maybe on another airplane.
I don't agree with you. It's not a matter of hope, it is a matter of to comply with your promise.
Yes.
You told me you are going to fly that flight, and you are going to do so.
Yes.
Because if not, you will be in trouble with me.
But I'm very proud of them,
yeah.
And I'm also very proud to be your friend for all your accomplishments in flying.
Thank you very much. Same thing.
Aside from catching up with Michel, the reason I was here was to take a closer look at one of Spain's earliest and most important contributions to aviation, the Autogyro. Capable of landing almost vertically, Autogyros differ from conventional helicopters in that lift is created by an unpowered rotor, while an engine-driven propeller in front provides forward thrust. Invented in the 1920s by pioneering Spanish aviator Juan de la Cierva, autogyros are considered to be the predecessors of today's modern helicopters. I met Colonel Fernando Rosello, who still flies these aircraft and has even written a book about them.
I understand you hold the world record.
I use 8 hours and 5 minutes to fly 1,305 kilometers.
Mm.
Okay? And because of that, I have not only the distance world record, but the speed world record.
Congratulations.
Okay. I started flying gyrocopters in 2003, because I was really amazed by this way of flying.
Yes.
And I had the opportunity to try it in Palma de Mallorca and in Zaragoza at the end of the 90s. I wanted to fly this machine.
Colonel Fernando's interest in autogyros come from a deep respect for de la Cierva's pioneering work.
Juan de la Cierva was the father of the rotary wing flying.
Mm.
And all the helicopters you can imagine in the world, the Symmetry of Lift have something of the ferrotos of Juan de la Cierva.
Mm.
During his time, aircraft development was still in its infancy, and safety issues claimed a lot of pilots' lives.
He decided to dedicate his life to find a way of flying safer. This is the starting point of the Autogyro.
A common problem for rotor aircraft was the instability caused by a phenomenon called the symmetry of lift.
He was very aware of the problem of the dissymmetry of lift.
Yes.
Okay? A lift is a phenomenon that happens when you are flying with a rotor and you are taking speed.
Correct.
And then you have a blade that is just advancing into the wind, another one that is advancing downwind. And then in order to control this, he put this configuration with two counter-rotating rotors, but this machine was not able to fly successfully. Eventually, he discovered the flapping hinge. This is the flapping hinge.
Oh, okay.
Yes. This is the like dimension of the wheel for cars. In rotary wing, this is the dimension of wheel. You know.
The flapping hinge solved the problem of instability in flight, as it allowed for more flexibility in each rotor blade, compensating for the dissymmetry of lift. The blades of the autogyro rotate thanks to the speed of the air as the plane moves forward, acting like a movable wing. This wind-driven rotation made the autogyro safer than airplanes and helicopters at the time. If the engine stopped, it would simply glide down a gradual descent, rather than crash to the ground.
But again, we all have to thank Juan de la Cierva for all of this.
Yeah. He not only did this, he developed the first theory, and the actual theory for rotary wind is an evolution of the first theory of Juan de la Cierva.
I was very lucky to be introduced to no less than Juan de la Cierva's great-granddaughter herself, Laura de la Cierva. Laura has made it her life mission to keep her great-grandfather's legacy alive.
I'm an artist and graphic designer, but nowadays I'm trying to make my license of pilot of Auto Gyro as well. And I have a very great project that I'm construing. Three replicas of this one,
yes.
the Auto Gyro of my great-grandfather, that is called Juanito C30, the project.
Okay.
And we will make it all over the world to make Juan de la Cierva go back to the sky.
Wow!
Yeah. So,
and you will be the one to fly it?
Of course.
She's determined to continue the work that she believes Juanito left behind.
This is the last one that Juan de la Cierva made because he died with just 41 years in a regular airlines flight from Croydon, London to London. Amsterdam. Mm-hmm. And he died in a disaster.
Oh yeah, that's terrible.
This is the last one that he made, and I want to develop this. Mm-hmm. I want to make the same strategy, but with different changes.
What changes did you want to make?
In the inside, to put a GPS and old motor, and in the rotor head,
yes,
to make a new system, to make that it doesn't have any vibrations, so just to improve.
Laura also shared how Juan de la Cierva thought about the flapping hinge in the rotor blades, which was a revolutionary idea that solved a lot of safety issues.
He invented that because of the skirt of a dancer, you know, in a ballet.
Yes.
He invented that because he observed that the dancer, when he's in a route, okay, this way of the skirt goes fast.
Exactly.
And it goes slow.
Slow.
So it was the articulation of arrastre. I don't know how to say.
Yes, yes.
Yeah, it's related into mathematics.
I hope my grandchildren will be doing this for me.
I hope so.
Because it's very nice to see somebody very proud of their heritage and their family is very, very nice.
Yes, sir.
Congratulations with your work.
Thanks so much.
As Laura would say, the future is invented in the past. This is exactly what her great-grandfather did. As modern aircraft later built on the knowledge and understanding achieved by De La Cierva.